Hello guys, welcome to the CCNP R&S class. Today we will be discussing the root bridge election. I am your trainer, Himanshu. I am a CCNA. I hold expertise into the CCNA, CCNP Routing and Switching, CCIE Routing and Switching, and also hold expertise in the CCNA Security and F5 Load Balancer. Let's start. You need a basic knowledge of the IP header and the layer 2 header to understand this class. So let's start. Okay, so first thing that's come to mind when we study about the STP or hear about the STP, what the STP is meant for? Why do we use the STP? So STP, the main purpose is to avoid the loops, the layer 2 loops. Okay, for it, the first thing the switches do, they elect the root bridge. Root bridge election takes place. So root bridge election takes place according to the bridge ID of the switches. Now that is another fancy terms. So what does the bridge ID means into the switching? As per the if we talk about the switches, what does the bridge ID means? So bridge ID is composed of three terms. First is the priority, second is the VLAN ID, and the third is the switches MAC address. Okay, now we know about the bridge ID. Now how does the root bridge election take place according to the root bridge ID, or you can say simply the bridge ID? So we have the switches. For example, we have the two switches, three switches. Now what they do, they exchange the BPDUs, and what these BPDUs are? BPDUs are the message through which the switches communicate, or to the the STP communication takes place through the BPDUs, bridge protocol data units. Now in that BPDUs, they will exchange their bridge ID, which is composed of the three terms as we have discussed earlier. So whichever the switch have the lowest bridge ID will win the election and will become the root bridge. Okay, once the root bridge has been elected, now as soon as the root bridge will elected, it's all of its port will become the designated port, that is the DP in short terms. Okay, now we have, now accordingly the root bridge has been elected. Now what other the non-root bridges will do? The non-root bridges, first of all, they will search the shortest path to reach the root bridge. Okay, or you can say they will see through my ports. Okay, it has, for example, one port, two port, or maybe more ports. So out of these, which the best port is? Now the criteria of the best port is the shortest distance to reach the root bridge. Okay, that port will become the root port, or in short, it is known as the RP. Okay, after the root port has been elected, right, the ports in front of the root port always become the DP, that is the designated port. Okay, now you will see that some of the segments, you will see the election has been occurred, DP, RP, and some of the segments will be non-elected, means on the whole segment there no election of ports has been occurred. Now for that segments, we have to select the DP and the block port. Now what is the criteria to elect the DP and the port or the root port? So the criteria is this. So this is the five criteria that we go through. Okay, first of all, they have to agree on the root bridge ID. They always agree. Okay, the root bridge is the same for all the switches. The second criteria is the root path cost. Okay, for example, two switches are competing, which of their port will become the DP or which of the other switch port will become the block port. Okay, so according to this criteria, the DP will be elected, right? So second is the root path cost. So out of those switches which are competing, whichever the switches port, or you can say the root port, has the lowest cost to reach the root bridge will become the root port, or you can say the DP will become the designated port. Okay, then if the root path cost of the two switches are same, then we go to the next criteria, that is the sender bridge ID. Okay, bridge ID is again the same that we have discussed earlier. Okay, and even the sender bridge ID is same. Sender bridge ID will be same in what case? In the case when they are getting the BPDU from the same switch. Okay, they are getting the BPDU from the same switch. So what will happen when even they are getting the BPDU from the same switch, then The next, we will go to the next criteria, that is the sender bridge ID. Okay, then according to the, sorry, the sender port ID, then accordingly the sender port ID, the designated port or the root port will be elected. Then even the sender port ID is same, maybe you are getting the from the same port you are getting the BPDU, but in between there is a hub. Okay, from the hub we are connected to the another switch through the two ports. Then as the receiving ports are different, so in that case the election will take place according to the receiving port ID. Okay, so these are the tiebreakers that will decide the root ports. Okay, so let's go to the practical and see into our lab. So what will happen, or we can also discuss in our lab. So we are going to navigate to our lab and we will discuss what is going to be there. And I will also teach you regarding the what the logical topology on which we are going to work. So let's start. So the logical topology that we are going to work will be, there will be a switch 1, switch 2, switch 3. Okay, so they are connected like this, right? So by default we will see out of this 3 switches which have the lower bridge ID. Okay, so we will see automatically the election will take place and that switch will be elected as the root bridge. Okay, for now we don't know because we don't know their bridge IDs. So we will see what their bridge ID is, then we will see which switch will become the root bridge. Then what we'll do, we will manipulate the priority and we will make another switch as the root bridge instead of the default chosen one. Okay, so let's go and look into our lab. So that is a CCNP lab. So I'm going to start the switches. Switch 1, switch 2, and switch 3. So I'm going to take the console of the switch 1 by clicking on it, the switch 2, and the last one is the switch 3. So let's give them the host name first so that we could remember on their console which switch we are working on. Switch 1, that is a switch 1, that is a switch 2, and the last one is a switch 3. So I'm giving just the host name now. Now let's go and look into their MAC addresses and also look into their bridge IDs. So first of all, show the spanning tree. Okay, so when you will look into this output, you will be able to see two things. First of all, you will be able to see the root ID, that is the information of the root bridge ID. And second of all, you will see the bridge ID, that is the information of the local switch on the switch we are working. Okay, so in the particular case when that switch is the root bridge, you will see that these two ID will be the same. Okay, and even you will see a message that this bridge is the root bridge. Okay, so if we talk about the priority, that by default priority of all the switches are 32768. That is by default 32768. But you will ask me, so why here it is 32769? Because of the VLAN ID. As VLAN 1 is the default VLAN and it is already present on the switch, so that will add to the default priority of the 32768 plus 1. That is a VLAN ID of VLAN 1. Okay, so that is a priority, and the address is actually the layer 2 hardware address, that is a MAC address, and then the cost, the port. Okay, and here you will see the root bridge is the AABBCC00.1800. Okay, so that is our root bridge. Okay, and that is our local. Okay, local means we are on to the switch 3. Okay, so its MAC address is AABBCC00.1800.
.cc00 and 3800. So that is its MAC address.
Okay, and you can also check out the MAC address using the show version. Okay, so let's move on to the next switches. Switch 2, type down the command show spanning tree, same command, and it's, you can see from here, that is its MAC address. So switch to MAC address is
.cc00.2800.
okay, and I think the remaining switch is the switch 1, whose MAC address is, who is elected as the root bridge, 1800. Okay, so let's go on to the switch 1 and see the output of the show spanning tree. Okay, so you will see here the message, this bridge is the root and both of the IDs are matching. Okay, so this means the switch 1 has been elected as the root bridge. Why? Because the priority of all the switches are the same, 32769. Then the next tiebreaker will come, will be the MAC address, as the MAC address of the switch 1 is the lowest of the three, so it will be elected as the root bridge. Okay, and even you can see all of its port here, the all of its port has been elected as the DP, or you can see the designated written onto the right. So now what we are going to do, we are going to make the switch 2 as the root bridge. So how we are going to achieve it? We are going to achieve it by giving it a lower priority than the root bridge. So its priority is 32768. So I will assign it a priority of, let's say, 0. Okay, and it has a VLAN 1, and you will see the priority that will come out as the 1. Okay, so let's go to the switch 2 and reduce its priority from 32768 for VLAN 1 to 0. So spanning tree priority, spanning tree VLAN 1 priority 0. Now let's check out the output. Okay, so now you will see that switch 2 has become the root bridge, and you will see the message here, this bridge is the root. Why it has become? Because the priority has been lowest of all of them three, that is 1. Okay, so accordingly this switch has become the root bridge. Okay, so now it's all, both of its port has become the DP, and now let's go to the switches, okay, and see which of their port has become the RP, other switches. Right. Okay, so that's what we have done. So now we are going to go to the switches, switch 1 and switch 3, and we'll see their output, what is the port that has been elected as the RP. Okay, so you will see that interface 3/1 has become the root port from here. Okay, so interface 3/1 of the switch 3 has become the root port, right? Okay, so let's again look into the election one more time, right? So our switch 1 was having a MAC address, is having a MAC address of 1800. Switch 3 is having a MAC address of 2800. Because the rest of the two ports are the same for the MAC address, and this one is having the 3800, right? So by default, as the switch is having the lowest MAC address, as the priority is the same for all of the switches, so it has the lowest MAC address, so according to the lowest MAC address, it has become the root bridge. That is by default. But what we have done, we have made the switch 2 as our root bridge by reducing its priority, because priority is the first criteria. First the priority is checked, then after that the MAC address is checked. Okay, as the priority of switch 2, we have reduced it to 0 but it has a wheel, one VLAN already, the VLAN one. So total priority will be one. Okay, so it has the lowest priority of these three. So this switch will become the root bridge. Okay, and accordingly, the spanning tree will converge, and it's all of the ports of the switch 2 now will become the designated port as we have discussed earlier. Right, and now we will see onto the switch 1 and to the switch 3 which port will become the root port, okay, and which port will become the designated port. So we are into the switch 3. You will run the show spanning tree command and you will see the output that port 3/1 has become the root port. Okay, so you can also check using the show spanning tree. Okay, you can check also from here with this command directly. You will see the root port, show spanning tree root, and you will see here that this has become the Ethernet 3/1 is the root port. Now let's also go to the switch 3 and check which port has become the root port, show spanning tree. So it's Ethernet 1/1 has become the root port. Ethernet 1/1 has become the root port, that is the RP and RP. You can also check the same output using the root show spanning tree root command. So you can see Ethernet 1/1 is the root port. Now the election between this segment is remaining. Okay, which one of these two on this segment? Now neither one is the root port, neither there is the DP. So the segment which are remaining, we will select one port as the DP and one port as the block port. Now how we will select it? So the criteria is the same. First is the root bridge ID. They all agree on the same root bridge ID switch to. Second is the root path cost, as that is the Ethernet port. So the cost is going to be same. Ethernet has the cost of the 100. And similar way, it also has the cost of 100. So that criteria also fails. So let's move on to the third one. Third one is the sender bridge ID. Okay. So out of these two switches, whose bridge ID is lower? Right? Priority is the same, 32769. We haven't manipulated it. So now you will see the MAC address. Its one is 1800, it is 3800 at the end. And all of the terms are the same. So the lower one will win, and this switch port will become the designated port, and this switch port will be the block. Okay, so that's how our spanning tree is going to get converted. So let's check on to that switch 3. Okay, so it has block port, that is Ethernet 3/2, 3/1, okay, and 2/2 and 2/2. So its port are, that are block are these, right? So if you will see onto the switch 1, you will see it's all of the port are the designated port, right? So that is our diagram and how the topology has been converged accordingly we have discussed, right? And that is the way. And you can also manipulate the, for example, now we have manipulated the root bridge election accordingly, the STP has converged. Now you can also manipulate the cost of the ports, right? The timers also into the STP for convergence purpose, more efficient convergence or according what you want in your STP, right? So you can change the different parameters. Okay, so that was all regarding the spanning tree root bridge election. Okay.